Last November, BuildBlock journeyed to Santa Fe, New Mexico to visit a Habitat for Humanity project where BuildBlock ICF were being used. Here are some takeaways from volunteers and staff members on their experiences using ICF for the first time, and how ICF aligns with the goals of their organization.
Jacqueline Ulrich, I am the Design Build Specialist with Santa Fe Habitat for Humanity. With our regular volunteers, some of them are of the age where things are getting harder to lift for them. So these blocks are light, they're easy to maneuver. I mean, they kind of do the work for you. They lock into place pretty well, as long as you don't booger up the teeth too much. Talk to your concrete subtractors not to step on the stem wall course. I mean, it's a pretty forgiving product. In the field, in the construction field, whenever in the computer when you're drafting it, it's not as forgiving if you don't understand the module. But in the field, it seems that it's fairly easy to put together.
Well, before this process started, you know, we got on some videos and looked at what others had done. So we had a little bit of a feel for it. It wasn't totally void. However, there's a lot more little steps involved. You know, when you first envision this, it's a tinker toy thing. You're building a bunch of blocks and pour some concrete in it and off you go. Well, it's not quite that straightforward. But once you know what you're doing, which I only know a little bit about what I'm doing, actually it's a pretty interesting process. I think a very could be a very cost-effective process, as based on the competitive ways of building a house. So
the learning curve wasn't bad. The key thing is, once again, to make sure all your webs align. And if you do that, that's probably your number one rule. And if you do that, everything sort of fits together. You do occasionally need to cut a block, and that takes some education on how to best do that, and we in fact had to invent a little tool that was an ICF scraper to shape things down, which was somebody developed that.
So we were excited to try it out, and then when we found out the dates were November 1st through the 5th, we all decided we were going to come all the days, even though normally we only volunteer 2 days a week or 3 days a week. No, it's very interesting to see how it goes up. And you guys are great. You have trained us very well. I think we caught on. We made some mistakes. We'd do better the next time, but it really, once you learn the groove thing, how to count right, and so you always have them in the right place, then it's really easy to put them up. And the doors we built just a little different than we normally would, the door frames, and it was a learning curve on how to put on the bucking. But once we figured that out, that you can just go like this, it was easy peasy.